محمد دكتورة أحياء مجهرية، راح أبدي معكم اليوم إن شاء الله بالمحاضرة الأولى من السيستميك بكتيريولوجي. In this lecture, we'll start with the systemic microbiology. You learned in the previous lectures that the bacteria are prokaryotes, consist of more than 300,000 species. They differ in their shapes, motility, habitat, oxygen requirements, temperature, and replication time. They are grouped according to their shape, into cocci, bacilli, or curved rods, or according to their gram stain or oxygen requirements. To the according to the shape, into cocci, bacilli, spiral bacteria, or according to their gram stain, into gram positive or gram negative bacteria, and according to their oxygen requirements, into aerobic and anaerobic bacteria. From the lab, you learned that there is a difference in bacteria in their composition of the cell wall. So some bacteria are stained with gram-positive stain, and others are stained with gram-negative stain. نعم دكتور.
دكتور أنسام، العفو، البرزنتيشن ما طالع.
لحظة.
ايه هسه اوكي، ينفع يحمل.
تمام، طلع سنتر.
ايه هسه اوكي، ايه طلع أوكي. طلع،
شكرا دكتور وليد. The gram positive bacteria, the composition of the cell wall contains a thick peptidoglycan layer, so it retains the first stain and stained with gentian violet and appear as violet in color. While the gram-negative bacteria, the peptidoglycan layer is very thin and it contains lipopolysaccharide layer, which is dissolved by alcohol and retain the saffron in color and appear as red in color. So the gram-positive bacteria appear violet in color, while the gram-negative bacteria appear red in color due to the difference in the composition of the cell wall. Today we'll start with the genus Staphylococcus. In this lecture, the most commonly encountered staphylococci, their characteristic and the infections they produce will be discussed. Also their laboratory identification. The Staphylococcus, from its name, spherical in shape, gram-positive cocci. The staphylococci composed of several species, many of which may be encountered in human clinical specimens. The members of this family are gram-positive bacteria, arranged either single, pairs, or tetrades, or cluster-like, grape-like appearance, which is a very characteristic in the genus Staphylococcus. The family Staphylococci. They grow aerobically, which means in the presence of oxygen, and can be facultatively anaerobic microorganism, which means when there is absence of oxygen, they can also grow. So Staphylococci are gram-positive cocci. All the Staphylococci are gram-positive spherical cells arranged in single pairs, tetrades, or usually in grape-like irregular clusters. They are non-motile. Some bacteria have the ability of motility, while Staphylococcus is a non-motile microorganism. Non-spore-forming microorganism. Some bacteria can form spores which can resist the environmental conditions. Staphylococci are non-spore-forming microorganism with limited capsule formation. 90% of Staphylococci have the ability to form capsule. Aerobic or facultatively anaerobic. That means they can grow in the presence and absence of oxygen and are catalase positive. All the staphylococci have catalase enzyme, which can differentiate them from the streptococci. Catalase enzyme produced by all species of staphylococci. The genus Staphylococcus composed of several species. Many of them are part of the normal flora. The staphylococci can be encountered in human clinical specimens, and they could be present on skin, skin folds, and any parts of the body as a normal flora. When there is a break in the defense mechanism, they can enter and cause different types of infections. This is the microscopic appearance of staphylococci in general. We can't differentiate between them in the microscope. All appear as gram-positive cocci arranged in single pair tetrades, and the most important characteristic feature is the grape-like appearance. Grape-like appearance. Some pathogenic species of staphylococci produce an enzyme called the coagulase enzyme. So the detection of this enzyme in lab used to identify the pathogenic species. So according to the production of coagulase enzyme, they are classified into coagulase positive, which include Staphylococcus aureus, the most important pathogenic species, and coagulase negative staph, which includes the other species of Staphylococci, which are more than 35 species encountered in clinical specimen causing human infections. So all Staphylococci produce catalase enzyme, all Staphylococci, while coagulase enzyme produced only by Staphylococcus aureus. The coagulase negative staph, more than 35 species, the most important clinically Staphylococcus epidermidis, or also called albus, and Staphylococcus saprophyticus, which is also called citrus. According to the coagulase enzyme, they are coagulase positive, which is Staphylococcus aureus, the pathogenic species. The coagulase negative, the most important clinically, Staphylococcus epidermidis and Staphylococcus saprophyticus. This is the microscopical appearance of Staphylococci, Staphylococcus aureus, either single, pairs, tetrades, or grape-like appearance. The morphology and identification of Staphylococci in general. All Staphylococci have the same microscopical appearance. You can differentiate between them under the microscope. They are gram-positive spherical cells about 1 micrometer in diameter, arranged in irregular clusters, non-motile and non-spore-forming. طبعا بالجرام استيا ما ممكن نشوف الموتيليتي لان هي already fixed smears. نشوفها بال smears اللي نحضرها بnormal saline. والسبورز ممكن نشوفها بالجرام استيا تكون على شكل empty space inside the bacterium. بالنسبة لستافيلوكوكس هي non-motile و non-spore-forming. This is the microscopical appearance of staphylococci in general. All the staphylococci have the same microscopical appearance. سواء كانت aureus, saprophyticus, أو epidermidis. Cultural characteristics. Staphylococci grow on most bacteriological media. أختم بالعملي أنواع البكتيريولوجيكال ميديا اللي ممكن تكون simple أو enriched أو special purpose culture media. بالنسبة لستافيلوكوكاي ممكن تنمو على simple culture media in aerobic and facultative anaerobic condition. Simple culture media اللي يختموا بالعملي مثل nutrient agar. They grow rapidly at 37 degrees centigrade but form pigments best at room temperature. يعني أول مرة راح نزرع البكتيريا بالإنكوبيتر at 37 degrees centigrade. بعد ما نطلع من الإنكوبيتر إذا بقيها بالروم temperature راح تتوضح عندنا البيجمنت. Staphylococcus aureus usually forms golden yellow colonies. Staphylococcus epidermidis forms white colonies. This is Staphylococcus aureus, and this is the golden yellow colonies. Staphylococcus epidermidis and white colonies. Staphylococcus saprophyticus, 50% of them form this golden yellow colonies. Lemon yellow. Lemon yellow by Staphylococcus saprophyticus. فإذا النيوتريانت أجار ممكن تنطينا بيجمنت، تنطينا فكرة أولية عن السبيشيز اوف ذا مايكروغانزم، بس ما نعتمد عليها بالتشخيص. Staphylococcus aureus golden yellow، Staphylococcus epidermidis white colonies، والستافيلوكوكس saprophyticus lemon yellow colonies. ذكرنا أنه الكاتاليز انزيم produced by all the staphylococci which can differentiate them from the streptococci. Streptococci are catalase negative, while staphylococci are catalase positive. Staphylococci are resistant to drying, heating for to 50 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes, and are inhibited by certain chemicals. They have different patterns of resistance. May have beta-lactamase production, which make the microorganism resistant to many penicillins, or may have MYC agent, which make the microorganism resistant to nafcillin, methicillin, oxacillin, or vancomycin resistant staph, which and also have the plasmid mediated resistance to tetracyclines. Now we'll start with the first species, which is the most important pathogenic species, the coagulase positive staph, which is Staphylococcus aureus. Staphylococcus aureus is the most important human pathogen among the staphylococci. It's found in the external environment and in the internaries of 50%. The nasal carriage in patients admitted to hospital is common because a close contact among patient and hospital personnel is not unusual. So there is an increased incidence of colonization in patient and hospital workers, which frequently occurs. It can be present in scale folds, perineum, axilla, and the vagina. Transmission of this bacteria may occur by direct contact with unwashed hands and also by inanimate objects like fomites and other objects. So the importance of this microorganism is both in the hospital acquired infection and in the community acquired infections, which is caused by drug resistant strains, which have been increased in the last 20 years. So Staphylococcus aureus is the most important pathogenic species among the staphylococci. Can be recovered from any clinical sample. And it's an important cause of hospital acquired infections, also can cause community acquired infections. As we mentioned, the internaries are the principal habitat for Staphylococcus aureus. Approximately 50% of people are either permanently or intermittently colonized. موجود بالانترنيريز in 50% of people, either intermittently or permanently. There are three types of Staphylococcus aureus. Nasal carriers have been distinguished, either persistent carriers على طول موجودة الميكروorganism بالانترنيريز or intermittent أحيانا تختفي وأحيانا ترجع مرتلخ. And the non-carriers اللي ما موجودة عندهم أصلا بالanterior nares. From the anterior nares, Staphylococcus aureus can be transferred to the skin and other body areas. The nasal colonization plays a crucial role as a source of invasive infections. The throat, intestine, vagina, and the skin folds, axilla, perineum are also found to be regularly colonized. Why is Staphylococcus aureus a pathogenic microorganism? Staphylococcus aureus is a pathogenic microorganism because it have the ability to secrete enzymes, toxins, and it contains many virulence factors. First, we have the capsular polysaccharide, which is present in 90% of staphylococci. It's important for the adherence of the microorganism to the cells of the body. So it's important in the virulence of the microorganism. Second is the peptidoglycan layer, which can activate complement and enhance polymorph for nuclear leukocytes chemotaxis. Third, we have the tachyoic acid and the lipotachyoic acid. It's important for the adherence to the mucosal surfaces of the patient. And also, we have the protein A. Protein A binds to the Fc portion of the immunoglobulin G and interfere with opsonization by the leukocytes. So binding to the IgG in this manner can block phagocytosis. So there will be no phagocytosis of the microorganism, which is also important in the virulence of the microorganism. Staphylococcus aureus have many virulence factors, as we mentioned, also can secrete many types of toxins. First, catalase. Catalase is not specific for Staphylococcus aureus. It can be secreted by all staphylococci. All the staphylococci are catalase positive. It inactivates hydrogen peroxide in the phagocytic cells. Second, we have the coagulase enzyme. Coagulase enzyme produced only by Staphylococcus aureus, which changes fibrinogen to fibrin that coat the bacterial cell with fibrin to be more resistant to phagocytosis. And there are two types of this enzyme, either bound coagulase, which is bound to the cell wall of the bacteria and directly convert fibrinogen to fibrin, causing the bacterial cell to be coated with fibrin and hide the microorganism from the immune system. Also, it's called clumping factor. The free coagulase is found free around the bacterial cells, is found free form in the medium, and directly convert fibrinogen to fibrin, leading to clot formation. The other enzyme is staphylokinase, which causes fibrinolysis, which aids in the spread of the microorganism. Hyaluronidase is another enzyme produced by Staphylococcus aureus, which is also called the spreading factor. It hydrolyzes the intracellular matrix and aids in the spreading of the microorganism in the subcutaneous tissues. Lipase enzyme, which is present, secreted by the bacteria, and aid in the spreading of the microorganism in the cutaneous and subcutaneous tissues. Proteinase also, and beta-lactamase, which is important in the antibiotic resistance. So Staphylococcus aureus, among all the Staphylococci species, can secrete many types of toxins, enzymes, and have many virulence factors. For that reason, it's the most important pathogenic species. Toxins produced by Staphylococci are produced locally and spread to a distant areas to affect the body in a systemic manner. So the microorganism may multiply at a localized site and exert their pathogenic effect by producing exotoxins that act at distant sites. One of them is the exotoxin. Exotoxin could be alpha, beta, and it causes cytotoxic effects on the bacteria, on the body cells, on the RBC, leukocytes, and other cells. So it's called cytolytic toxin. The alpha type causes beta hemolysis when inoculate the microorganism on sheep blood agar. It's responsible for the beta hemolysis. And the beta type have a cytotoxic effect for the monocytes and other bacterial cells. Enterotoxin. Staphylococci secretes the enterotoxin, which is a heat-stable exotoxin, resists boiling for 30 minutes and is responsible for cases of food poisoning. It may cause vomiting, diarrhea, which occurs within 30 minutes to 24 hours, and is secreted by 30 to 50% of staphylococci. The other toxin is the toxic shock syndrome toxin 1, which is responsible for the toxic shock syndrome. Exfoliative toxin is epidermolytic toxin which causes Staphylococcus scalded skin syndrome, leading to generalized desquamation of the superficial skin layer. And also the leucocytine, which kills the white BCs. So the infections caused by staphylococci depend on the strain of the microorganism, type of toxin produced by this microorganism, size of the inoculum, status of the immune system, all can determine the type of infection caused by this microorganism. The infection starts by break in the skin or mucosal barrier, which allow the access of the microorganism to the tissues or blood. The microorganisms are able to resist the action of inflammatory cells by production of toxins and enzymes and establish focal lesion. So the infection depends on the strain, toxin produced, and inoculum of the microorganism in addition to the immune system of the body. The infections caused by Staphylococcus aureus are either superficial infection, deep infections, or toxin-mediated infections. The Staphylococcus species are classical opportunistic colonizing the skin and the mucous membrane, but may become pathogenic in a species and strain-dependent manner following a break in the cutaneous epithelial barrier through trauma or medical interventions. The recovery of Staphylococcal isolate always requires assessment and clinical significance to determine whether it's a contaminant, colonizer, or pathogen. Superficial infections caused by Staphylococcus aureus are usually suppurative, which means pus-forming infections. The microorganism is a suppurative microorganism, which means cause infections with abscess formation, which could be mild infections, severe, and life-threatening infections. The superficial infections could be impetigo, folliculitis, furuncle, carbuncle, or wound infection. Folliculitis means inflammation of the hair follicle. Impetigo is a larger infection surrounded by erythema, and it's confined to the dermis. Furuncle is the also named boil, extension of the folliculitis to the deeper infections. Carbuncle is a more invasive lesion which forms multiple furuncles in the deeper tissues. It may also cause deeper infections, which includes endocarditis, osteomyelitis, and so on. In this picture, this is a sty, which is a purulent infection of the eyelid, folliculitis, boil, and carbuncle. The deep infections, osteomyelitis, pneumonia, acute endocarditis, which could be native or prosthetic valve endocarditis, arthritis, meningitis, bacteremia, septicemia, and abscess of brain and kidney. These are infections caused by the microorganism and its proliferation. Some infections are caused by the toxin of the microorganism. So the infection could be urinary tract infection, endocarditis, osteomyelitis, and the microorganism from this local site can secrete the toxin, which spread by the blood and exert its effects at distant areas. Example is a toxin-mediated illness, scalded skin syndrome, which is caused by strains that produce the exfoliative toxin, which could be due to urinary tract infection, as we mentioned, septic arthritis, endocarditis. These are the source of the microorganism. Secrete the toxin, spread at distant areas, and cause the syndrome. It appears as bullous lesions at a localized or generalized area, then sloughing of the superficial skin layer. It's also called Reiter's disease, characterized by rash over most of the body, like burned skin, upper layer of the skin peel off. It occurs most often in newborn baby with low mortality rate about 3%. It also occurs in adults and patients with severe infections with low immunity. So it had a poor prognosis because the patient already have low immunity. With high mortality rate may reach to 50%. As we mentioned, the Staphylococcus aureus produced the toxin at the site of infection, and the toxin traveled to the blood and caused the syndrome. This is scalded skin syndrome. And there is a desquamation of the superficial skin layer. The other syndrome is the toxic shock syndrome, which is also a toxin-mediated infection caused by Staphylococcus aureus. Toxic shock syndrome is a fatal multisystemic disease manifested by an abrupt onset of high fever, vomiting, diarrhea, myalgia, skin rash, and skin peeling with hypotension, cardiac and renal failure. And the mortality rate may reach to 1 to 3% if treated. If not, it may reach to 70%. And there is a strong association between toxic shock syndrome and tampon use, in which the primary site of infection is the vagina. And during menstruation, the bacteria can grow on tampon and accumulate at a dangerous level if not changed. So the bacteria proliferate locally and secretes the toxin, which extends systemically and causes the toxic shock syndrome. The disease is caused by toxin released by the bacteria, and it often occurs within 5 days after the onset of menses in young women who use tampons. But it also occurs in children or in men with staphylococcal wound infection. Even in this condition, the microorganism may proliferate in the wound, secrete the toxin, and the toxin spreads systemically and cause toxic shock syndrome. The other toxin-mediated infection caused by Staphylococcus aureus is the staphylococcal food poisoning. Staphylococcal food poisoning is caused by staphylococcal toxin, enterotoxin, released in the food. It doesn't occur due to ingestion of live bacteria. So it's not important to ingest the bacteria. Only ingestion of the toxin, and there is also no infection site, not like the other previous two syndromes. So there's no benefit if we heat the food. If we heat the food, we will kill the bacteria, but the toxin is a heat-stable enterotoxin. So it's not affected by heat, and it causes vomiting within 30 minutes. The symptoms may appear within 30 minute to 7 hours, characterized by abdominal cramps with or without diarrhea, no fever, and the condition resolved within a 24-hour. So, the gram-positive cocci, if we do gram staining, and we found the result is gram-positive cocci, first test to do is catalase test. أسرح أسألكم أشياء اللي يعني اللي افتهمتها من المحاضرة. مثلا عندنا تيجان خالد، افتح السماعة تيجان. تيجان خالد تيجان خالد تيجان، إذا طلع عندنا جرام بوزيتيف كوكاي عملنا لها كاتاليز تيست، منو تتوقع من الكاتاليز بوزيتيف ومنو الكاتاليز نيجاتيف؟ ما تعرفين؟ زكريا علي، زكريا.
اي نعم دكتورة،
عملنا ستاند سلايد ستاند وذ جرام ستاند. طلع عندنا جرام بوزيتيف كوكاي، اريد اعرف هاي جرام بوزيتيف كوكاي ستريبتوكوكاي ولا ستافيلوكوكاي. ايش اعمل له تيست؟
كاتاليز،
كاتاليز تيست احسن.
اما راح تكون بوزيتيف او نيجاتيف.
زين
البوزيتيف راح تكون ستافيلو كوكاي، والنيجاتيف راح تكون ستريبتوكوكاي.
اكسلنت، تمام، شكرا دكتور. توفيق ماهر، توفيق معي؟
نعم دكتورة، نعم دكتورة معك.
دكتور هسه طلع عندي كاتاليز بوزيتيف اوف تو هاي ستافيلوكوكاي، زين
نعم.
انا اريد اميز الباثوجينيك سبيشيز عن النون باثوجينيك سبيشيز، ايش اعمل له ايما تيست؟
تيست كوجوليز،
كوجوليز احسن. الكوجوليز تيست راح يفرق لي الباثوجينيك سبيشيز اللي هي ستافيلوكوكس اوريوس فروم ذا نون باثوجينيك سبيشيز اللي هي الكوجوليز نيجاتيف ستاف. اكسلنت، شكرا دكتور. زين يوسف امجد، هذا ما امتحان بس الشكل دشع معي ما معي، مركزين ما مركزين. يوسف امجد، الو هتسمعني؟ كوثر اسلام،
اي دكتوره.
هلا دكتوره كوثر، هسه انا عملت الكوجليز تاكدت طلعت عندي كوجليز بوزيتيف، تاكدت هاي ستافيلوكوكس اوريوس. الكوجليز نيجاتيف ستاف الموست امبورتنت كلينيكلي منهم هي
الابيديرميدس وال
سابروفيتيكس. اكسلنت، شكرا دكتور. زين هسه ستافيلوكوكس اوريوس تأكدت منها موجودة لأن عرفت أنه هي كوجليز بوزيتيف. أتأكد أكثر أكيد بالبايوكيميكال تيست راح نأخذها بالمحاضرة القادمة إن شاء الله. ستافيلوكوكس أوريوس تفرق عن باقي الستافيلوكوكاي أنه it can secrete many toxins and enzymes which are only secreted by Staphylococcus aureus. All these toxins and enzymes mentioned in the lecture are only secreted by Staphylococcus aureus. كل الستافيلوكوكس اوريوس are virulent microorganisms secretes many toxins and enzymes which only are specific for Staphylococcus aureus. الانزيمز مثلا كان عندنا الكاتاليز، الكوجليز، الهايالورونيديز، لايبيز، البروتينيز and so on. والتوكسين توكسينز التوكسيك شوك سيندروم، الانتيروتوكسين and other toxins. والفيرولنس فاكتور are also specific for Staphylococcus aureus واللي هي الكابسولار بوليسكرايد، تيكويك أسيد، البروتين أي and the peptidoglycan دير. واضحة المحاضرة؟ ما أكو سؤال عليها؟ ما أكو أي سؤال؟ ما أكو أي سؤال عندكم؟ أخشى أنا قلت أسأل الكل اختفى قل عدد الحاضرين. ما عندكم أي سؤال؟ إذا ما عندكم أي سؤال الله معكم، ممكن ننهي المحاضرة. وأشكركم على استماعكم، وإن شاء الله المحاضرة الجاية إن شاء الله نكمل الستافيلوكوكس إبيدرميدس وسابروفيتيكس وديجنوسيس مالتهم.